Ye and Balenciaga for a long time were synonymous with one another, with Ye being a regular ambassador for the brand and a good friend of Demna Gvasalia, Balenciaga's creative director. That was until just over a month ago now, when Balenciaga cut all ties to Ye and announced that they have no intention to work with him in the future. This was, of course, because of his anti-Semitic remarks made online and subsequent doubling down on these ideologies, something that has come to a head in recent days. But right after this, Balenciaga have managed to tarnish their own reputation with one campaign that has serious implications, not only for the future of the company, but for the legal ramifications that may ensue. Ye has spoken about Balenciaga cutting ties with him, claiming it made him feel free more than anything, as he claims he is looking to move away from big corporations to allow affordable clothing to be in the hands of people. While he still claims to be a good friend of Demna, and still wanting Demna to join the Yeezy team one day, going so far as to say he will be working for Yeezy one day. But the actual details of Ye and Demna's relationship and the separation from Balenciaga are unimportant to what we're talking about here. Balenciaga wanted Kanye off their team and didn't want to be associated with anti-Semitism or bigotry in any form. It seems that being adjacent to an artist with controversial and harmful views is not good for the brand's image, no matter how big the artist. But just over a month after the separation, Balenciaga have managed to create a campaign so offensive that their image may never recover. This is the first of the two campaigns in question. In case you can't immediately see the issue here, this is a campaign that features many adolescent children holding and posing with bears dressed up in bondage gear. This is a flagrant and glaring issue, so how did they manage to miss such an egregious combination for their collection? Some of these images even included children posing next to empty wine glasses to make matters worse. I think Hoop said it best when he tweeted, "Hey photographers, when Balenciaga hires you to shoot their new lookbook and you show up and find a toddler laid across a sofa with wine glasses and bondage gear around them, you walk away. Period." If that wasn't bad enough, the next campaign seemed to desire a bit more subtlety in its nefarious nature, with these two images taking the spotlight. The first seems relatively harmless, with a woman sitting in a Manhattan office styling the latest collection. That is until you look in the back of the scene, where a book celebrating the artist Michael Borrowman can be seen, a name that might be inconspicuous if you aren't familiar with him, but continues the theme of perversion. The David Zwirner Gallery in Hong Kong, where Borrowman's Fire from the Sun has been shown, described his paintings as toddlers engaged in playful but mysterious acts with sinister overtones and insinuations of violence. If that was too fluffed up of a sentence to read between the lines, Borrowman has illustrated an image which I have had to censor incredibly heavily, as this quote-unquote art illustrates an image of two young boys who have been recently castrated, still with blood on their skin. What's more, another image of this campaign, an image of a handbag atop a stack of papers, continued the disgusting themes already present. The document seen under this bag is a Supreme Court's 2008 decision in the case U.S. versus Williams. This court case was one where Williams was accused of promoting child pornography. So since he didn't actually create nor distribute any, he argued that he had not broken the law. The case was settled in 2008, and of course, Williams lost. Why this would belong in a campaign already fraught with these themes and images creates a clear and more repugnant picture than the individual infractions can communicate. So why on earth would Balenciaga do this? What artistic meaning could you possibly derive from implications of sexualizing adolescent children in any context? Well, thankfully, Balenciaga decided not to double down and released a statement addressing the situation. "We would like to address the controversies surrounding our recent ad campaigns. We strongly condemn child abuse. It was never our intent to include it in our narrative. The two separate ad campaigns in question reflect a series of grievous errors for which Balenciaga takes responsibility. In this document, for the first campaign, including the children and the bears, they bear full responsibility, saying that it was a wrong choice by Balenciaga, and that the responsibility lies with Balenciaga alone. However, for their second campaign, the campaign in the Manhattan office, they claim that the inclusion of the United States versus Williams report was actually due to negligence because of a set designer, something that they overlooked and didn't realize. They end it by saying, "We want to learn from our mistakes and identify ways we can contribute. Balenciaga reiterates its sincere apologies for the offense we have caused and extends its apologies to talent and partners." So Balenciaga claimed that the court document was an unauthorized inclusion in their set, but surely they they would at least be aware of the fact that this was a very real case. I understand a small oversight, but when you're a company as huge as Balenciaga, there is not room for mistakes at all, and they know this. So how did they miss multiple glaring issues in this campaign? Twitter has done what they've done best and sensationalized the very real situation, turning it into a question of Satanism versus Christianity. But this only helps in blurring the lines between who was at fault and who should be reprimanded, since the devil isn't really somebody that you can cancel for being problematic. Balenciaga followed this statement up with a second statement. Balenciaga takes the following actions with the objective to learn from our mistakes as an organization, detailing new control instances, their organization, the fact that they have decided not to pursue a lawsuit against the set designers, and how they want to learn, continue, and donate in the future. Demna himself has also released a statement about the infractions, where he stated, "I want to personally apologize for the wrong artistic choice of concept for the gifting campaign with the kids, and I take my responsibility. It was inappropriate to have kids promote objects that had nothing to do with them. As much as I would sometimes like to provoke a thought through my work, I would never have an intention to do that with such an awful subject as child abuse that I condemn. Period. I need to learn from this, listen and engage with child protection organizations to know how I can contribute and help on this terrible subject. I apologize to anyone offended by the visuals, and Balenciaga has guaranteed that adequate measures will be taken not only to avoid similar mistakes in the future, but also to take accountability in protecting child welfare in every way we can." So he was taking full responsibility as the creative director of the brand and effectively the face of the brand. Even Kim Kardashian responded to this controversy, ditching the brand and taking the opportunity to reevaluate her future with the brand. What that might come to mean, we don't really know. But we're not concerned about her. Ye himself was silent for a long time. Granted, his social media presence has been stunted by the well-deserved limitations put on his accounts. That was until Elon Musk decided to let him back onto Twitter, which created one of the most abhorrent media campaigns Kanye has let himself go on. While a lot of the content and imagery that came out of this is something I will be going through in another video, for now, let's focus on the Balenciaga and Demna focused tweets. The first tweet here is a text conversation between himself and Demna. He asked Demna, "What would you like me to say?" Demna replied, "Stop. Demna. Hate. Love. Love cures everything. Love Demna. Jesus loves everyone. God is love." Followed by a few tweets in support of Balenciaga. "God loves Balenciaga. Love is the answer. Jesus is the answer. Praying for all of the innocent artists and beautiful humans who make clothing that had nothing to do with the ads. People's grandmothers work there, for Christ's sake." Followed by, "I stand by Balenciaga and denounce all witch hunts, and I cancel culture. Jesus is king. Ending trafficking doesn't start or end with a fashion campaign, for Christ's sake." It seems that Ye is still on board with Balenciaga, despite tweeting about how pornography has ruined his life and his family. It seems strange that he wouldn't question the campaign, rather praising Balenciaga, claiming that it is within God's light. It seems like a blatant contradiction more than anything against his values, given the presence of bondage gear, but his love for Demna is not in question when these ideals are challenged. It's clear for anyone to see that Balenciaga made a huge mistake, a mistake that would take an incredible amount of negligence on the side of Balenciaga, and one that they are taking accountability for. The ideas of Satanism and devilish imagery are seeming more of a distraction to the real issue of the children's campaign using the bears as props, and the inclusion of a Supreme Court document that should never have been in there to begin with. The imagery here is clearly harmful, and not to be taken lightly, but the close ties to Ye, seemingly withstanding, spell doom for the company. Balenciaga continue digging their own grave, and Demna does not seem to want to get rid of Kanye, despite his clearly harmful and horrific views. In my opinion, the only way for Balenciaga to move forwards is to move away from Ye. Continue making clothing and keep a very, very watchful eye for the content not including these obscene insinuations. Maybe even stop making children's clothes for the time being if you can't help but include bondage gear and drinking glasses in your campaign. But lining up with Ye is not only harmful for your company, it's dangerous. Dangerous for the Jewish population of the world, and whoever Ye decides he wants to brigade against next. What this means for Ye, though, we don't know. His reputation is through the floor, and for good reason. He continues to be the most talked about person in the media, and yet again, it is never for a good reason.